Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we'll talk about different features of Raspberry Pi Pico. I will also compare the Raspberry Pi Pico with Arduino Nano and ESP32. Then we will learn how to program the Raspberry Pi Pico using MicroPython. We'll also make some project like temperature control relay module, automatic street light. So after watching this video, you will get a clear idea about Raspberry Pi Pico and use this board in your different electronics project. So let's get started. Raspberry Pi Pico is a low-cost, high-performance microcontroller board with flexible digital interface. I will highly recommend you to visit this page where you can find all the key features of Raspberry Pi Pico. I will share the link in the description. Now let's compare the Raspberry Pi Pico with Arduino Nano and ESP32 board. So here you can see Raspberry Pi Pico use RP2040 dual core microcontroller. The CPU clock speed is 133 MHz and it has 264 kilobyte SRAM. And there are also 26 GPIO pin, and there is also an inbuilt temperature sensor which you will use during making the temperature control relay module. And according to me, one main drawback of this Raspberry Pi Pico is there is no Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, and also there is no reset button and it don't support Arduino IDE, so you can't program the Raspberry Pi Pico using Arduino IDE. Now if you want to compare this Raspberry Pi Pico with Arduino Nano, then you can see Raspberry Pi Pico is superior than Arduino Nano. It has better RAM, clock speed is also higher than the Arduino Nano, and also there is dual core microcontroller. But if you want to compare the Raspberry Pi Pico with ESP32 dev kit, then you can see ESP32 dev kit is superior than Raspberry Pi Pico. You can pause the video to look at this comparison. And this is the pinout diagram of Raspberry Pi Pico, which you can download from this page. And you can also download the different documentation of Raspberry Pi Pico, which will be really helpful while you make any project. So please visit this page. You will find all the details about this board. To program the Raspberry Pi Pico, I will use Tony IDE. To download the IDE, you have to visit tony.org, and here I will download the Windows version. You can also use Mac version if you use MacBook. Now I will install it. It will take some time. Now I will click on finish. After that, I will go to this page and download this file. Again, I will share all the details in the video description. Let me save this file. Now I will open the Tony IDE, and then I will go to Tools, Manage Plugins, and here I will click on this Install from Local File. Then I have to select the file I have downloaded from the GitHub, and I will select the file and click on Open. It will install the plugin, and now I will click on Close. Now I will connect the Raspberry Pi Pico with the micro USB to connect it with my laptop. Then I have to click on this top icon. And if you are doing it first time, then it will ask you to install the MicroPython. So you just have to install the MicroPython to your Raspberry Pi Pico board. Now if you face any problem during installing the MicroPython, then again I will recommend you to visit this page. And if I go to Getting Started MicroPython, and then here you can see they have mentioned all the steps how to install the MicroPython to your Raspberry Pi Pico board. So first you have to download this file. Then I will go to my download folder and copy this file. Then I have to disconnect this Raspberry Pi Pico board, and I have to press this boot cell button and connect it with my laptop. After that, I will release it. You can see this window open. So I will paste the file here. After that, the Raspberry Pi Pico will reboot, and thus we can easily install the MicroPython. So here you can see they have shown all the steps with animation. Then I will go to run, select interpreter, and here I have to select the MicroPython Raspberry Pi Pico, and you have to select the correct port. Then click on OK. Now I will check whether the MicroPython is working to our Raspberry Pi Pico board or not. For that, again I will stop it, and to check that I will print a line to terminal. Now I will save it to our Raspberry Pi Pico board, and now I will select Raspberry Pi Pico. You can give any name. Let me give print.py. Click on OK. Now to execute it, I have to click on this green icon, and you can see hello world printed. So the MicroPython installed successfully. Let me upload the LED blink code to Raspberry Pi Pico board. So I will open another file and I will use this sketch. In the code you can see I am using the GPIO pin 25 as it is connected with the LED, and it will be a output pin. And this block of code is like void loop in Arduino IDE. This will execute repeatedly. So here you can see first we are changing the current state of the LED, then there is 1 second delay. So thus LED will blink after every 1 second. So again I have to click on this top icon, then I have to save this file to Raspberry Pi Pico board. Before that I will delete this file which we have created earlier. It is better to save the file as main.py, as whenever you supply the Raspberry Pi Pico from any different power supply, then first it will search for the main.py file, and accordingly it will execute the file. So I will save it as main.py and tap on OK. Now to execute it, I will click on this icon, and you can see the LED start blinking after every 1 second. Now we'll move to our next project, which is temperature control relay module. For that I have referred their documentation, or you can also visit their GitHub page. You can see all the example sketch is available here. So I will select the ADC. So I will upload this code now. Let me copy it. And in the Tony, first I have to stop it, and then I will paste it. So again I am using this main.py name. So whenever I will save it, it will overwrite the previous file. In this code we are using inbuilt temperature sensor of the Raspberry Pi Pico. So here you can see first it is reading the temperature value, then it is calculating the temperature value into degree Celsius. You can find the calculation details here, and after that it is printing the value. So let me execute the sketch, and you can see it is printing the temperature value after every 2 seconds. Now we will modify this sketch to control a relay module using this temperature value. So this is our final code for the temperature control relay module. Here you can see I will connect the control pin of the relay module with GPIO 22. You can use any other GPIO. You have to change this GPIO number accordingly. Then initially I am turning off the relay and the LED, as I am using active low relay module. So relay.high will turn off the relay. After that we are reading the temperature value. Then if the temperature is greater than 37 degrees Celsius, then it will turn on the relay, and if the temperature is less than 34.5 degrees Celsius, both LED and relay will turn off. So this is very simple code. Let me save the code, and again it will override the previous main.py file. You can refer this circuit diagram to connect the relay module with Raspberry Pi Pico. Here I have used GPIO 22. As you can see, I have connected the relay module with Raspberry Pi Pico. This is the GPIO 22. So connection is very simple. Now let me execute the code. You can see currently the temperature is 32 degrees Celsius. So if the temperature becomes greater than 37.1 degree Celsius, the lamp will turn on. Now to increase the temperature, I will use a dryer. You can see the temperature is increasing. And currently the temperature is 40 degrees Celsius and the lamp automatically turns on. And you can see this LED also turns on. Now slowly the temperature will decrease, and when the temperature will become less than 34.5 degrees Celsius, the lamp will automatically turn off. So we have to wait some time for that. And currently the temperature is 34 degrees Celsius and the lamp automatically turns off. Now I will use my mobile charger to supply 5 volt to this circuit. So as I have saved the code as main.py, so I can use any power supply. Again I will increase the temperature. You can see the lamp automatically turns on. Now when the temperature will become below 34 degree 5 Celsius, the lamp will automatically turn off. You can also connect a fan instead of lamp. Now we'll make the automatic street light using Raspberry Pi Pico. You can refer the circuit diagram for this project, and you can see I have connected the LDR with GPIO 28, which is also a ADC pin of Raspberry Pi Pico, and I have connected the relay module with GPIO 22. I have connected this LDR as per the circuit diagram, and this is a 10K resistor, and I have connected this relay module with GPIO 22. So now I will quickly upload the code to Raspberry Pi Pico board. For that I will open the Tony IDE, and now I will connect the micro USB cable with Raspberry Pi Pico. Then I will go to run, select interpreter, and here I have to select the MicroPython Raspberry Pi Pico, and you have to select the correct port. Then click on OK. Then I will go to file, open, and select the Raspberry Pi Pico. Here you can delete the previous main.py file. I will click on OK, close it. Now this is the code I will use for this automatic streetlight project. Here you can see the relay is connected with the GPIO 22, and we'll read the analog value from the LDR from GPIO 28, which is a ADC pin. Then with this block of code, you can see first we are reading the value from the LDR, and we are reading the value after every 0.2 second. Then if the value is less than 9000, then we are turning on both LED and relay. Or if the value is greater than 13000, then we are turning off both LED and relay. And as I am using active low relay module, so relay.high will turn off the relay. Now let me save this code, and here I will save it to Raspberry Pi Pico. And as I said, I will save this file as main.py. So if you get this error, then just close the Tony IDE. I will say no. Then again open the Tony IDE. I will paste the code and I will try to save it again. I will select Raspberry Pi Pico, and here I will save the file as main.py. Now if I try to execute it, it's showing me the reading. Now this value depends on the ambient light condition. Let me turn off some light. You can see the value will change. So as you can see, if I turn off all the light, it's showing me the reading 38,000. And if I turn on all the light, it's showing me the reading 65,000. So accordingly, I will change this value. I will stop it. So here I will type 39,000. And here I will type 65,000. Now I will stop this code and I will save it again. Now let me execute it. Currently the value is greater than 65,000. So LED and relay is turned off. Now I will turn off all the lamp. You can see the lamp automatically turns on. Now let me turn on all the lights. You can see the lamp automatically turns off. Now let me remove this USB cable. And I have already given the 5-volt supply from my mobile charger. So again, let me turn off the lights. You can see the lamp automatically turns on. If I turn on all the lights, the lamp turns off. So thus you can easily make this automatic street light using Raspberry Pi Pico. In this video, we have discussed different features of Raspberry Pi Pico, and we have also made temperature control relay module, automatic street light using the Raspberry Pi Pico. And you can also visit our website IoT Circuit Hub to download the code and circuit diagram that I have used for this project. So if you find this video helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such projects. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.